Now we shall divulge our darker purpose. Attend the King of France, Gloucester.
I will, my lord.
The map! There. No, we haven't three divided our kingdom, intending to shake off the cares of rule, conferring them on younger strengths. So tell me, my daughters, that we are largest bounty makers, then which of you shall say doth love us most? Donner or eldest, speak first.
Sir, I love you more than words can wield the matter. Dearer than eyesight, space, or liberty, beyond all manners of so much, I love you.
All these bounds, even from this line to this, shall be to thee and Albany. Now, Regan.
I profess myself an enemy to all other joys. I'm only happy in your dear hands, his lord.
To thee remains this third of our fair kingdom. Now, Cordelia, what can you say to a third more opulent than your sisters? Speak.
Nothing, my lord.
Nothing will come of nothing. Speak again.
Why should my sisters' husbands, if they say they love you all? When I shall wed, my lord shall carry half my love with him.
So young and so untender.
So young, my lord, and true.
Let it be so. Thy truth then be thy dower. Hence, and avoid my sight! Here I give her father's heart from her. Call France! Who stays? Cornwall and Albany, digest their third. I do invest you jointly in my power, and I shall make my bow with you by turn with a reservation of 100 knights.
Royal Lear, my old master, what wouldst thou do? Reverse this hideous rashness, answer my life. Your youngest daughter does not love thee least.
Out of my sight, vassal, miscreant. Turn thy hater back in our dominions.
God's God be made, who hath most rightly said. And your speeches may your deeds approve.
My lord of France, who rivaled for our daughter, there she stands, dower only with our curse. Virtue liking a more worthier way.
As this is most strange.
I've lost my father's liking, for I lack my sister's glebe and oily art, to speak and purpose not.
Thee, and thy virtues I seize upon, thy dowerless daughter, king. Thrown to our chances, is king of us, and ours, and to our fair France.
How hast thou, France? We have no such daughter. Come!
Do you see how full of change he is?
'Tis the infinity of his age.
We must accept more unruly waywardness as Kent and Cordelia's banishment.
We must do something, and in the heat.
Thou nature, O my goddess, to thy law my service are bound. Wherefore should I stand in the plague of custom and permit the curiosity of nations to deprive me, for that I am some 12 or 14 moonshines, lad of a brother? Wherefore base, when my dimensions as well as compact, my mind as generous, as my shape as true, as other manners issue, why brand they us with baseness, bassity, base? Who in the lusty stealth of nature then doth take a stale tied bed, go and creating a whole tribe of fops, but to be in a sleep and wake? Well then, legitimate Edgar, I must have your land, A mother's love is the bastard Edmund as the legitimate. Fine word, legitimate. Well then, legitimate. If this letter speed and my invention thrive, Ebon the base shall top the legitimate. I grow, I prosper. Now, gods, stand off the bastards!
How now, Edmund? What were you reading?
Tis for my brother, but not have time to.
If our mother would sleep till I wake her, you shall enjoy half of her revenue. Villain! Sleep till I wake her! Unnatural, detested, brutish villain! Go. Seek him. Apprehend him, Edmund.
Ah! Brother Edmund!
When you saw my mother last, did you part on good terms?
Eh?
Think how many offender. She's in a rage against you.
Have some villain done me wrong, brother?
That's my fear. Stay with me until her rage abates. And if you go out, go armed.
Armed, brother?
Brother, I advise you for the best. Come, retire with me to my lodgings.
Day and night he wrongs me. Every hour he flashes into one gross crime or the other that sets us all at odds. And I'll not endure it. His nights grow riotous and himself upbraids us on every trifle. When he returns from hunting, tell him I'm sick. If he distastes it, let him on to our sisters, whose mind and mine I know are not one to be overruled. Idle old man, old fools are babes again, and must be used with checks as flatteries.
Very well, madam.
Now, if I can borrow another accent, I can save my master whom I love. Eels. Eels. Fucking eels. Fucking can. That eel is a fucking cunt.
Fine now. What art thou?
I'm a man who can serve you, sir. I can ride, run, keep honest counsel, and deliver a plain message bluntly.
Thou shalt serve me. Dinner ho! You, sir! Where's my daughter?
So please you.
Call that crop-pulled back! Where is everyone? I should think the world's asleep. How now? How came that mongrel not back when I called him?
Sir, he said he would not.
He would not?
No, I don't think you're treated with the same kindness by the servants here, nor by your daughters.
That reminds my own perception. You, sir, come hither. Who am I?
My lady's father.
My lady's father, you cur.
I will not be struck, my lord!
Nor tripped, you base football player! Come here, you fucking cat. Get over here.
Now, my friendly knave, I thank thee. There's an earnest of thy service.
Let me hire him too! Here's my coxcomb!
How now, my pretty knave? How dost thou?
Sirrah, you had best take my coxcomb!
Why for?
Why for taking one's part that's out of favour? Nay, and thou canst not smile as the wind sits, thou catch cold shortly. There, take my coxcomb. Why, this fellow has banished two once daughters and did the third a blessing against his will. If thou must follow him, then thou must needs wear my coxcomb. How now, uncle? Would I had two coxcombs and two daughters?
Why, my boy?
If I gave them all my living, I'd keep my coxcomb myself. There's mine. Beg another of thy daughters.
Take heed, sirrah, the whip.
Treats a dog must to kennel. He must be whipped out when Lady of the Brack may stand by the fire and stink.
This is not in fool.
Can you make no use of nothing, uncle?
I know, boy. Nothing can be made of nothing.
Oh, prithee, tell him so much the rent of his land to come. He will not believe a fool.
A bitter fool?
Dost now know the difference, my boy, between a sweet fool and a bitter fool?
No, lad. Teach me.
That lord that counseled thee to give away thy land, come place him here by me, do thou for him to stand. The sweet and bitter fool will presently appear, the one in motley here, the other found out. There.
Dost thou call me fool, boy?
And all thy other titles that thou was born with that thou hast given away.
This is not altogether fool, my lord.
Give me an egg, Nuncle, and I'll give thee 2 crowns.
What 2 crowns shall they be?
Why, after I have cut up the egg in the middle, and eat up the meat, the 2 crowns of the egg, when thou clovest thy crown and gavest away both parts, thou borest thy ass on the back over the ditch. Thou had no wit in thy bull crown when thou gavest the golden one away. If I speak like myself in this, let him be whipped that fierce finds it so.
When were you wont to be so full of song, sirrah?
Ever since thou madest thy daughters thy mothers. For when thou gavest them the rod, and puts down thine own breeches. Prithee, uncle, keep a schoolmaster that can teach a fool to lie. I would fain learn to lie.
And you lie, sirrah. We'll have you whipped.
I marvel at what can thou and thy daughters are.
How now, daughter? What makes thy frown on? Maybe you were too much late in the frown.
That was a pretty fellow when thou hadst no need to care for her frowning. Thou art an earl without a figure. I am a fool. Thou art nothing. Yes, forsooth, I will hold my tongue, so your face bids me, though you say nothing.
Not only, sir, this you all a licensed fool, but other of your insolent retinue do hourly carp and quarrel, breaking forth into rank, and not to be endured riots.
May not an ass know when the calf draws the horse?
Doth any here know me? This is not Lear. Did Lear walk thus, speak thus? Where are his eyes? Either his notion weakens, discerning a lethargy, heart waking. Tis not so. Who here can tell me who I am?
Lear's shadow.
I would learn that, for by the marks of sovereignty, knowledge, and reason, I should be false persuaded that I had daughters.
Come, sir, I would you make good use of what wisdom I know you are fraught, and put away the dispositions that of late transform you from what you rightly are.
Which they will make an obedient father.
Your name, fair gentlewoman.
Sir, this admiration you do to beseech is of greater debt. I do beseech you to understand my purpose aright. As you are old and reverend, you should be wise. Here you do keep 100 knights and squires, men so debauched and bold that our court is infected with their manners. Epicurism and lust ache it more like a tavern or a brothel than a graced palace. Be then desired by what she begs, for you know.
Darkest devils! Saddle my horses, call my train together. Degenerate bastard! I'll not trouble thee, yet I have left a daughter.
You strike my people, and your disordered rabble make servants of their betters.
Woe that too late repents. Oh, sir, are you come? Is it your will, sir? Speak, sir, prepare my horses. Ingratitude, thou marble-hearted fiend, more hideous when thou showest thee in a child than the sea monster.
Pray, sir, be patient.
Detested kite, O most small fault. How ugly is thou in Cordelia show, like an engine wrenched to my frame of nature from its fixed place, and drew from heart all love, and added to the gall. Oh, Lear, 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 beat to the gate that let thy folly in, and thy dear judgment out. Go, go, my people.
Sir, I am guiltless as I am ignorant. Of what hath moved you?
That may be so, my lord. Hear nature, hear dear goddess, hear. Suspend thy purpose if thou did intend to make this creature fruitful. Into her womb convey sterility. Dry up her organs of increase, and from her derogate body never spring a babe to honour her. If she must teem, create her child of spleen. I mean, live and may thwart this nature torment to her. List up wrinkles in her brow of youth, with cane tears tread channels in her cheeks. Turn on other mother's pain and benefits into laughter and content, that she may feel how sharper than a serpent's tooth it is on a thankless child. Away! Away!
This news waves itself into my business. My mother has sent a guard to take my brother Edgar away. But there is one thing I must do. Brother, descend! Oh, sir, by this place, my mother's family, you are hid and sent a guard to take you. Pardon me, I hear her coming. I must pretend to draw my sword upon you. Yield, come before my mother. Stop! Stop! This way! Mother! Mother!
No, Edmund. Where's the villain?
Fled that way, madam.
Pursue him! After him!
He tried to persuade me to murder you. But when I refused, lanced my arm, and when I shouted, fled!
The noble Duchess of Cornwall comes tonight. By her authority, I shall proclaim her royal thanks to whoever can bring this loathsome murderous villain to the stake. She comes. Boy, I'll find means to advance you.
How now, my noble friend?
What did my father's godson Edgar seek in your life?
If he be taken, he shall never do more harm. Edmund, we hear that you defended your mother.
Aye. He betrayed his plot and got this here.
Such virtue and obedience do we need. You shall be ours. We seize upon you here.
I serve you truly, madam. However else.
We came because our sister wrote of differences best answered from our home.
I serve you, madam. Your graces are right welcome.
Friend, where may we set our horses?
In the mire.
Why do you speak this? I know thee not.
I know thee for a proud, shallow son of a mongrel bitch. And you know me, for I tripped and beat thee the other day. You rogue, you come with letters against the king.
Murderer! Oh, keep peace upon your lives! What's the matter, this ancient ruffian, sir?
I'll tread this villain into mortar and daub the walls of Jake's with him.
Why art thou so angry?
These smiling rogues know only to obey the passions of their lords like the curs they are.
Why dost thou call him that?
His countenance likes me not.
No more, perchance, does mine, nor hers, nor his.
I have seen better faces than ones that stand before me in this instant.
Stubborn ancient fool! Fetch the stocks.
I do beseech thee, my lady. The king must take it ill to see his messenger so slightly used.
My sister may receive it much worse to find her gentleman abused and assaulted. Put in his legs. Let him stay there all night.
your sorrows to be friend to the Duchess's disposition.
My Lady of Gloucester.
Coming, my Lady.
Oh, I've travelled. Some time I'll rest. Fortune, good night. Turn thy wheel.
I heard myself proclaim that I have escaped. Like a bird from Beckett, I'll grind my veins. And with my nakedness, I'll outface the wind. With prayers of man, I'll beg for charity.
Noble master.
What is he that then set thee here?
The Duchess, sir, and your daughter.
I daren't do such outrage on my man. Tell me how I deserve this usage.
When at their home I gave them your letters, came another post from Gonrail. Straight away they took horse. I followed, meeting here the other messenger. I foolishly drew upon them. Then your daughter-in-law and daughter found my trespass worth the shame it lies here.
They could not, they would not. This is worse than murder. Where is this daughter?
With the Earl, sir, here within.
Follow me not, stay here.
Need you no more friends for what you speak of?
None. Ah, chance the king come with such smaller train.
And thou'd been set in the stocks for that question. Thou hadst well deserved it.
Why, fool?
We'll set thee to school to an aunt, to teach thee there's no labouring in the winter. All that follow their noses are led by their eyes, but blind me, there's not a nose among 20 but can smell them that's stinking. Let girl thy hold when a great wheel runs down a hill, lest it break thy neck with following it. But when a great wheel runs up the hill, let him draw thee after. When a wise man gives thee counsel, give me mine again.
Well, learnt you this, fool?
Not in the stocks, fool.
Then I speak with me. They are sick. They are weary. They have travelled all night. Mere fetches. The images of revolt and flying off. Fetch me a better answer. Death on my state. Wherefore should he sit here? Good morrow to you both.
I'm glad to see your highness.
Oh, Regan, I think you are. Oh, are you free? Some other time for that. Beloved Regan, thou not believe how the prey of the quality, thy sister's not. Oh, Regan.
Oh, sir, you are old and should be led by someone much wiser than yourself. Therefore, return to my sister and say you wronged her.
My curse is on her.
What? Ask her forgiveness.
Dear daughter, I confess that I am old. Age is unnecessary. Pray, give me bed and food.
No more unsightly tricks, sir. Return to my sister.
Never, Regan. She hath baited me of half my train, looked black upon me, struck me with her tongue. All heaven's vengeance fall on her.
Oh, the blessed God, so will you wish on me?
Oh, Regan, thy tender nature would never grudge my pleasures and cut off my train.
Hark, my sister, she wrote she'd be here.
Who put my man in the stocks? But who comes here? Oh, Regan, will you take her by the hand?
Why not? All's not offence that dotage terms so.
Besides, you are too tough. Will you yet hold? How came my man in the stocks?
I set him there, sir.
You? Did you?
Father, return to join with my sister. Missing half your train, then come to me.
Return to her, and 50 men dismissed. I'd rather choose to abjure all roofs and wage against the enemy to the air.
At your choice, sir.
Prithee, daughter, do not make me mad. We'll no longer meet, no longer see one another. I'll stay with Regan and my 100 knights.
Not altogether, sir. What, 50 followers? Why should you need more or so many? I entreat you to bring but 5 and 20.
I'll go with thee. Thy 50 yet thought double air 25, and thou art twice her love.
What need you 5 and 20, 10 or 5, when all of our servants are at your command? What need one?
Oh, reason not the need. Heaven give me patience. You see me here, you gods! A poor old man. Let woman's tears not stain my man's cheeks. I will have such revenge on you both. I will do such things. What they are, I know not, but they shall be the terrors of the earth. You think I'll weep? No, I'll not weep. For this archer breaketh 100,000 pieces, there I weep. Oh, fool. I shall go back.
Let us withdraw. Tis his own blame. He must taste his folly.
The king is in high rage. He calls the horse, but will I know not whither?
Tis best to give him way. He leads himself.
But the night wind comes on. For many miles about their scarce a watch.
Oh, sir, to willful men the injuries they do themselves must be their schoolmasters. Shut up your doors, my lady. Come out of the storm.
And drown the cocks, you sulphurous thought executing fires, you fog couriers to okay cleaving thunderbolts, singe my white head. And now, all shaking thunder, smite flat the thick rotundity of the world.
Oh, nuncle, caught holy water in a dry house is better than this rainwater out the door. Good nuncle, in and ask thy daughter's blessing. Here's an eye pity's neither wise man nor fool.
Rumble thy belly full. Spit, fire, spout, rain. Nor rain, wind, thunder, fire, my daughters. I never gave you kingdom, called you children. Here I stand, your slave. A poor, despised, weak old man.
Who's there?
Marry. Here's a grace and a cop piece, that's a wise man and a fool.
Let the great cause that keep this devil upon our heads fight out their enemies now. I am a man more sinned against than sin.
Good my lord, hard my ears and our bull. Some friendship raised you against the tempest. Repose you there.
My wits begin to turn. Come on, my boy. How does my boy? I'm cold myself. Where is this straw, fellow? The art of our necessity is a strange that makes wild things precious. Come, your hovel.
He that has in a little tiny wit, with a hey ho and a wind and a rain, for the rain it raineth every day.
True, my good boy. Bring us to this hovel.
I'll speak a prophecy ere I go. When priests are more in wealth than matter, when brewers more than malt with water, Then shall the realm of Albion come to confusion. At going shall be used in feet this prophecy Merlin shall make, for I live before this time. Warming you to entreat for the king or in any way sustain him.
Oh, savage or unnatural.
Say nothing. I have also retrieved a letter that I have locked in my closet. There's a plan on foot to revenge the king. I will go seek him and privily relieve him. If they ask where I am, say I've gone to bed. Pray you be careful.
All this to the Duchess instantly know.
There it is, my lord. Good, my lord. Enter. The tyranny of the open night's too rough for nature to endure.
Let me alone.
Good, my lord. Enter.
Wilt thou break my heart?
I'd rather break mine own. Good, my lord. Enter.
For Lalil ingratitude, as it not as this malchitaire's hand for lifting food to it. But I'll not weep no more, I will punish home. In such a night to shut me out, pour on, I will endure in such a night as this. O Regan, Goneril, your old kind father, whose frank heart gave all. Oh, that way madness lies, let me shun that, no more of that.
Good, my lord, enter.
Prithee, go in, seek thy own ease. This tempest will not give me leave to ponder, but I'll go in. In, boy, go first. Get thee in, house of poverty. I'll come in, I'll pray, and then I'll sleep. Poor naked wretches, whereso you are, abide the pelting of this pitiless storm. How shall your houseless heads, your unfed sides, your locked and windowed ragginess defend you from seasons such as these? I have taken too little care of this. Take physic, pomp, and expose thyself to feel what wretches feel, that thou may shake the superflex of them and show the heavens more just. Fatal omen's fault, light on thy daughters.
He hath no daughters, sir.
Dead, traitor! Nothing could subdue nature to such lowness but his own kind daughters.
Pilcock sat on Pilcock Hill. Halloo, halloo, halloo.
Oh, this cold night will turn us all to fools and madmen.
Take heed, O foul fiend. Obey thy parents, commit not with mad sworn spouse. Ooh, Tom to cold.
What hast thou been?
A serving man, proud at heart and mind, curled my hair, wore gloves in my cap, served the lust of mistresses, and did the act of darkness with her. Let nor the creaking of shoes nor the rustling of silk betray thy poor heart to woman. Keep thy foot from thy ruffles, thy hand from thy black, thy pen from thy lender's book. Oh, say some note that he doth it, my boy. Caesar, let it drop by.
Why, thou were better in thy grave than talk with a sort of covered body from the extremity of the sky. Is man no more than this? Consider him well. Off, you lendings. Come upon me here.
Uncle, tis a naughty night to swim in. Ah! Look, here comes a walking fire.
This is the foul fiend. Flippity gibbet. He begins at curfew and walks to the first cock. He grabs the web and the pin, squints the eye, makes the hair lift, makes the white feet, and hurts the poor creature of earth.
How fares your grace?
What's she?
Who's there? What is to seek?
What are you there? Your names?
Poor Tom, that eat the tadpole, the swimming frog. Oh, peace, smoking peace, thou fiend.
What? Hath your grace no better company?
The Prince of Darkness is a gentleman. He is known as Bodo. He is also known as Behu.
Our flesh and blood are grown so vile, my lord, that I don't hate what gets it.
Tom's a cold.
Come with me. My duty cannot suffer to obey nor your daughter's hard commands. Though the injunction be to bar my doors and let this tyrannous knight take hold upon you, yet I venture to come and seek you out and bring you here both fire and food is ready.
First, let me talk with this fox. What is your study?
To kill thy fiend and prevent from vermin.
Let me ask you one word in private.
His wits begin to unsettle.
Canst thou blame him? His daughter seek his death. Ah, good Kent. What a night's this. I do beseech your grace.
Oh, cry your mercy, madam. Noble philosopher, your company.
Tom the cold.
This way.
Stick with him. Still, I'll stay with my philosopher.
Good my lord, soothe him. Let here take the fellow.
Take him you want.
Senna, come on.
Come
along
Athenian.
With us.
Come on, come on.
Child Roland still went to that dark tower. His words are still big by bold fun. I smell the blood.
This letter proves my mother to be the Duchess of France. If this matter be certain, you have mighty business at hand.
True or false? It had made thee Earl of Gloucester. Seek out your mother, that she may be ready for our apprehension.
If I could only find her covering the king, I shall continue my loyalty to this Duchess. But though there's conflict between that and my blood.
I will lay trust upon thee, and thou shalt find a dearer parent in my love.
It shall be done. I will arraign them straight. Sit thou here, most learned Justifer. Thou say it, sir, sit here. Now, she foxes! Look where she stands and glares!
Good my lord, what stands you now so amazed? Won't you lie and rest upon the cushions?
I'll see their trial first. Bring the evidence! Thou, rogue man of justice, take thy place. Thou, his yoke, fellow equity, bench by his side. You in the commission, sit you too.
Let us deal justly.
Arraign her first, his Goneril. Here I take my oath before this honourable assembly. She kicked the poor king, her father.
Come hither, mistress. Is your name Goneril?
She cannot deny.
Cry, you mercy, I took you for a joint stool.
Here's another whose warp looks proclaim what store hard is made on. Stop her, there! Arm, sword, fire! Corruption in this place. False justice.
Why hast thou let her escape? Bless thy pied wits!
Oh, pity! Sir, where's the patience that thou hast so well boasted to retain?
The little dogs and all, Trey Blanche and sweetheart, see, they bark at me.
Tom will throw his head at them, afore to all your cares. Tom's horn is dry.
Let them unto my Regan, see what breeds of our hair heart. Is there any cause in nature that makes these hard hearts?
Good my lord, lie here and rest a while.
Make no noise, draw the curtains. So, we'll go to supper in the morning. So.
Where is the king?
His wits are gone.
There's a plot against his life. Bring him to Dover.
Come, help me bear him.
Go speedily to your wife. Tell her the army of France is landed. Seek out the traitor, Gloucester, and pluck out his eyes. Leave her to my displeasure. Edmund, accompany our sister. The revenges we ought to take upon your mother are not fit for your beholding. Letters had you from France, and where have you sent the old king?
Dover.
Where? For? To Dover.
Because I will not see thy cruel nails pluck out his borrowed eyes.
Thou shalt see nothing!
But better so if I have never done than this!
Be the most lowest and dejected thing is to know that there is nothing worse.
But who goes there?
Here's poor mad Tom, beggar and madman too.
Bless thee, master.
It was the last night that I such a fellow saw. My son then came into my mind.
Bless thee.
Sister Naked Fellow?
Aye, my lady.
Bring him some covering, then get thee gone.
Bring him the best apparel as I have.
Sarah, Naked Fellow, do you know Dover?
That I do. Bless thee, master.
There's a cliff towering above the sea. Bring me to the brim of it. I'll reward your misery with riches.
Give me your arm. I'll lead you there.
Come, my lord. Where's thy master?
Madam within would never mind so changed. I told him of the army that has landed, and he laughed. told him of Gloucester's treachery, and he said the worst.
Back, Edmund. Tell my sister Cornwall to hasten her army. You may soon hear a mistress's command.
Your ranks in death.
Tigers, not daughters. What have you done? A father and an old man? Are you mad at most barbarous and degenerate?
Milk-livered man. Villains are rightly punished.
Why dost thou cry?
Alas, why does he so?
If I obey my blood, I will destroy thee.
Marry your manhood. Mew!
The Duke of Cornwall has been slain by a servant for putting out Gloucester's eyes. This shows the gods do avenge our crimes. But poor Gloucester.
My sister a widow, and my Gloucester with her. That likes me not.
Does Edmund know of Cornwall's wickedness? Gloucester, I live to avenge thy eye!
Why is the King of France so suddenly returned?
Something importing danger on his state.
As Cordelia read how his sisters have used their father.
Aye. She cried. Sisters! Sisters! Shame of ladies. What? In the night? Well, her eyes ran holy water.
All ears in the town. We will not see her, for a shame grieves him so how he banished her. Of Cornwall now these powers, have you heard not?
Aye, they are afoot.
Come, sir. Let's go see our master Lear. Oh.
What can you do to restore his senses?
Our foster nurse of nature is provoked, which there are many simples.
Preparation stands in expectation. Father, it is thy business that we go about.
Brought my sister's letter to Edmund.
I know thee not, lady. I must ask
thee. I love thee if I might unseal it. I know your lady does not love her wife. I have seen her observing looks to Edmund's. Besides, my lord is dead and it's more convenient for my hand than is your lady's. Pray you, give him this. So fare you well. And if you do chance to light on that blind traitor, if Edmund falls on him, that cuts him off.
If I see him, madam, I will do my duty.
There we go. This is the place. Stand still. Fearful and dizzy it is to cast one's eye so low, 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 low. The crows that fly midway, they appear small as beetles. The men upon the beach, they appear small as mice. Now farewell, madam!
This world I do renounce, and patiently shake my great affliction off. If Edgar lives. Oh, bless him. Now, fellow, I fare thee well.
I tried him with his despair to cure it. How? Alive or dead? What is thee?
Away and let me die.
10 masks could not make the altitude that thou hast particularly fell.
Well, have I fallen or no?
Give me your arm. You stand. It is clear to see that the gods have preserved thee.
Henceforth, I shall bear affliction till they cry out.
But who goes there? They flatter me like a dog that say, hey, and no to everything I said. But when the rain came to wet me, and the thunder put a piece of my bidding, I smelled them out.
Oh, let me kiss that hand.
Let me wipe it first. It smells of mortality. Ha! No eyes in your head. Yet a man may see how this world goes with no eyes. Look with thine ears. Hast thou seen a farmer's dog bark at the beggar, and the man run from the cur?
Aye, sir.
There thou mightst behold a great image of authority, a dog obeying in office. I know thee. Thy name is Gloucester. Thou must be patient. Mark thou this.
Oh. Here he is. Lay hand upon him, sir.
Nay, and you shall get it. You shall get it by running. Sir, 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 sir.
A pitiful sight.
Hast thou heard aught towards a battle?
Everyone can hear the armies on the move.
Give me your arm, and I'll lead you away.
Oh. Proclaimed prize! Thou old unhappy traitor! The sword is out and must destroy thee! Let go thy arm, slave, or thou diest!
Come not near! Or I shall see whether that stick or this custard die harder.
Out, downhill!
Keep out!
Give my letters to Edmund, Earl of Gloucester.
Let's see these letters. Edmund, let our vows be remembered. You had many opportunities to cut him off. If he returned to conquer, then am I his prisoner, and my bed his jail. From which deliver me, your wife, I would say. Goneril, a plot upon the virtues of Albany's life, and the exchange, my brother. In time, I will strike thee with this paper. Give me your arm. I'll lead thee away.
How shall I live to match thy goodness, Kent?
To be acknowledged, madame, is our paid and privy.
So be it. How does the king?
Aye, your majesty. If you wish, we may wake him.
Be governed by your knowledge. Is he arrayed?
Aye, in the heaviest of sleep. But we've put fresh garments on him.
Oh, my dear father. Is this a face opposed against the warring winds? Against lightning and thunder?
He wakes. Speak to him.
Sir? You know me.
Where have I been? Where am I?
fair daylight. I know not what to say. I will not swear that these are my hands.
Sir, hold your hands in benediction over me. No. Sir, you must not kneel.
I am a very foolish, fond old man. And I think that I'm not in my perfect mind. But I think this lady to be my daughter, Cordelia. If thou hast poison for me, I will drink it. For I know you do not love me, for your sisters have done me wrong.
You see, madam, the rage is killed in him. But trouble him no more until further settling.
Will please your highness walk?
Thou must bear with me. I'm old and foolish.
Who is leader of the dead Cornwall's people?
As is said, the bastard son of Gloucester. The powers of the kingdom approach apace.
Now, sweet lord, do you not love my sister?
Yeah, an honourable love.
Methinks you are being together, I shall never endure it. Be not familiar with her.
Sister, I would rather lose the battle than should loosen him and me.
Sir, I hear that the king and his daughters are in a French camp, joined by other English malcontents.
Why is this reasoned? Combined together against the enemy.
Agreed. I'll meet you presently in your tent.
Sister, come with us. 'Tis most convenient.
Oho, I know the riddle. I'll come.
Your Grace, I pray you hear speech from old man. If you see victory, let the trumpet speak. I can produce a champion that can prove what was evoked here. Fortune, my love.
Fare thee well, I will overlook thy paper.
The enemy is in view. Draw up your powers.
We will greet the time.
To both these sisters, I have sworn my love. Neither can be enjoyed if the other one remains alive. I'll use Albley in this battle, and who wants her dead, devise her taking off. As for Lear and his daughter, when they are within my power, they shall never know pardon.
Take the shadow of this tree and pray that it right me fry.
Grace be with you.
King Lear hath lost the battle. He and his thoughts have been taken away. Oh, man, give me her. Let's go.
Guard them both until their fate be known.
Shall we not see these sisters and these daughters?
Pray, sing and tell old tales, pact and sex of great ones, that ebb and flow by the moon.
Sir, I have sent the old king and his daughter some attention, and appointed the guard.
Sir, I hold you as an ally, not a brother. We require the captives of you to use as their merits and our safety we may decide.
He led our powers, bearing my place, and may well stand up and call himself our brother. Witness the word I herewith create thee, Edmund, my lord and master.
The
for, let alone lie, not in thy good will.
Nor in fine, lady.
Half-blooded fellow, yes. If no one will appear to approve thy treasons in thy person, I will approve on thy heart.
What on the air that names me traitor? On she that dares approach, I will maintain my truth and honour firmly!
Herald, ho!
Oh, I am sick.
If not,
the sickness grows.
I'll ne'er trust the poison.
She is unwell, convey her to my tent. If any man will maintain upon Edmund's supposed Earl of Gloucester that he is a traitor, he shall appear by the sound of the third trumpet.
Sound!
Again!
Thy name is lost by treason's tooth been on, and am I not as noble as my adversary? Who is thee that speaks for Edmund, Earl of Gloucester?
Himself, what sayest thou to him?
My sword and spirit are here bent to prove that thou art a toad-spotted traitor in conspirate against thy high, illustrious prince, false to thy brother, thy father, and thy son.
I will ask thy name, but that do I spurn. That do I toss these treasons at thy head, which my sword will give instant way. Trumpets, speak!
I asked her blessing. Tord Twix creep bare smilingly.
Help! This came from the heart of... She was dead.
Who's dead? Speak, man!
A lady. And her sister by her is poison.
The other one, poison.
chosen for my sake, that we may all marry at once. Said quickly, though my wit is upon the life of the king, a Cordelia.
Run for thy life.
Well, here comes Kent.
I have come to bid my king and master a good night. Is he not here?
Help! 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 She's gone forever. A plague upon you! Murderous strangers all! Cordelia, stay a little. What dost thou say? Her voice was there soft, gentle and low. I killed the slave that was hanging me. Who are you? Are you not Kent?
I am that very man. But from the first, followed your sad steps. The eldest daughters have killed themselves.
Aye, so I think.
He knows not what he speaks. My lord's friends, we resign, joring in the life of this, his majesty.
Why should a dog, a horse, a half of life? Thou, no, brother, no. I'll come no more. Look on her. Look, Ellen. Look back.
Let him pass. We have endured so long.
Fare then hence. Present business. Friends of my soul, you twain rule in this realm and the god's state of sustain.
The way to the sad time we must obey, and speak what we feel and not what we say. The oldest had borne most, but we that are young should never live or see so much.